The Empress Dowager Xiao Zhuang was the princess of Keqing Mongol Buryeji-Jite clan. She was born in 1613, the Ming Emperor Wanli's time. In 1625, the 13-year-old Xiao Zhuang was arranged to be married with Huang Taiji as Fu Jin. Huang Taiji was 20 years older than Xiao Zhuang. Besides, about 10 years ago, Huang Taiji already married Zhe Zhe, who was the sister of Xiao Zhuang's father. In some legend, Xiao Zhuang was selected in this political marriage because a prophet predicted that in future, Xiao Zhuang would become the empress. In real historical documents, no such records. In my opinion, Xiao Zhuang was chosen just because Zhe Zhe needed a close relative to give birth a son for Huang Taiji. Zhe Zhe married Huang Taiji in 1614. In 10 years, she never gave birth a child. In early 1625, Zhe Zhe finally gave birth a child, a girl. Later in the same year, Xiao Zhuang joined this family. In 1626, Huang Taiji became the second Kehan of the later Jin. Because there wasn't records about Huang Taiji's inner court in this period, so we don't know Xiao Zhuang's rank in the later Jin. In the following 6 years, Zhe Zhe gave birth another 2 girls. Xiao Zhuang gave birth 3 girls. Well, Huang Taiji already had 3 surviving boys. In 1634, Huang Taiji's oldest son, Hao Ge, was already 25 years old and got the 3rd rank prince title 2 years ago because of his military contributions. So, in 1634, Buryeji-Jite clan arranged the 3rd political marriage with Huang Taiji. This time, Xiao Zhuang's older sister, Hai Lanzhu, was arranged to marry Huang Taiji. In this year, Hai Lanzhu was 26 years old. Considering Asian people usually got married between 13 to 17, it's highly possible that Hai Lanzhu married someone before. Anyway, no matter what happened before, Huang Taiji quickly fell in love with Hai Lanzhu. In 1636, Huang Taiji founded Qing. He adopted Ming rules and set ranks for his imperial women. But only 5 imperial women got formal titles. Zhe Zhe was promoted to Qingling Gong, Zhonggong Guozhu Fu Jin, which was equal to the Empress. Meanwhile, Zhe Zhe got the power of managing the inner court. Hai Lanzhu was promoted to Dong Guanju Gong Fu Jin, which was the highest rank consort. Xiao Zhuang was promoted to Xi Yongfu Gong Fu Jin, which was the lowest rank consort. In 1637, Hai Lanzhu gave birth Huang Taiji's 8th son. To celebrate the birth of beloved son, Huang Taiji published an amnesty, which equally public announced this boy was the crown prince. Unfortunately, this boy only lived for several months, and he was too young to have a name. Only 2 days after Huang Taiji lost his beloved son, Xiao Zhuang gave birth Huang Taiji's ninth son, Fu Lin. At that time, Hailan Zhu and Huang Taiji were feeling desperate for losing their beloved child. Do you think Huang Taiji had mood and time to pay a little attention to Xiao Zhuang and her newborn baby? In Huang Taiji's time, although Xiao Zhuang didn't have chance directly manage the inner court, but she had chance of helping Ze Ze, so she had many experience in managing a big family. Besides, in Huang Taiji's time, there wasn't rules to prevent royal female members to participate in political affairs. So Xiao Zhuang had a chance to learn how to deal with political affairs. In 1643, Huang Taiji suddenly passed away without appointing a heir. This year, Xiao Zhuang was 30 years old. Fu Lin was 5 years old. Fu Lin wasn't born by an empress, and he didn't make any military contributions to the country. Besides, Qing was attacking Ming. Common sense tells us that Fu Lin had a general advantage in the throne competition. So,